Welcome back to the Elder Kings. Last episode, we got independence from our liege. We became the steward of King Abnathan, arguably the most powerful man in the Empire, head of the Elder Council, King of Nibonet, and more importantly, we got three provinces, which allows us to form a duchy-level title. Right now, actually kind of a pain in the ass, which I didn't really consider, because we've only got 52 gold. To make the duchy-level title, we need 178. We're 5 out of 3 on our domain size, so this is probably going to cost us money to hold these provinces for the time being. Have we actually got a better place than our capital? Yeah, this one here, Sejanus, is actually slightly better than what we've got already. Plus, there are ruins there. Could also make an argument for... Oh, man, it's on a trade route. That's cool. Could also make an argument for maybe moving all the way to the coast so that we have a coastal kingdom. Probably would go for Cropsford because there is a straight crossing between those two. What's the other one? All right, Magia. Oh, that's also a four... Oh, but it's a temple. Right, got it. Okay, ignore me then. I was going to say that's four extra provinces, but don't worry about that one too much. We can now go raiding because we have ships on the coast, or at least I assume we have a boat. I won't say ships on the coast. We don't exactly have a navy. We just have one rowing boat capable of taking 100 men raiding. But hey, 100 men is better than no men, and we're not completely boxed in now by, you know, everybody on every side. Let's look at the independence map mode. There we are. We've actually made it up with the big boys now. That's pretty incredible stuff. I'm a big fan of that. Our old liege, we could also swallow up at some stage because we've already defeated him one war. What's another one, hey? Argonians seem to be kicking off a little bit. The Waster Conquest of Deep Scorn, sure. The Dunian Cyrodiil de jour war of a dune, and then what's the Emperor doing? Oh, he's muddy. He's covered in his own shit there. Why? Normally that happens to popes in the base game when they come to coronate you and then they slip over or something like that. But this guy is just covered in mud. Okay, fine. No idea why. I won't even begin to question it. So for the time being, we need to basically find ways of making money. We're part of the Fighters Guild. That's a good way to make money. I kind of want to flip over to the business focus so we can maybe debase some mints. That will in turn... Oh, shit. It's like a couple more months. Then we'll just blitz through to that one. Oh. Wow. It seems Count Ortho Skinnier wanted to become my new liege, but King Abner has chosen to give me a claim on Count Ortho instead. You... shithead. So, the other guy I'm talking about, King Abner of Nimene, tell me this isn't working as intended. Becoming the steward to one of the most powerful men in the world apparently has its benefits, and he also does kind of like us too. Let's try and sway this guy. I'm a big fan of you. You've got my vote for the next emperor, so I do love intrigue. So, the county, although it sounds not very good, counties are duchies in this one, right? They absolutely are. Oh my god, I said we could potentially conquest this dude, and apparently it's right on... Did he also punch him in the face? How dare you suggest something like that? Whack. Also gave us a claim on his territory, which we could push right now. Oh shit, no, we can't push right now. We could assassinate him. Could assassinate him, maybe kill him off. How much would an assassin cost us? We could go business focus for a while, make our own duchy level title, or go business focus for a while, use that money to pay assassins to kill this guy off, and just push our claim on his duchy. That way we wouldn't need to make our own. Becoming a double duke in such a short period of time is gonna be fantastic. Let's let some time tick here. We gain 150 prestige, he gains 150 prestige and we owe him a favor. Okay, fair enough. He bailed us out during a meeting, essentially. Thank you, I appreciate that one, my friend. This is cool. We've also apparently got a... claim on that? For who? Oh, our father. Our father apparently has claims on a distant Nordic kingdom. I'm not too bothered about that one too much. Right, okay then. So I guess we'll just blitz through to the seventh month. Then we'll flip over to business, see if we can't make a decent amount of money out of that. Maybe do some raiding. I mean, it's a big maybe, seeing as we've got an boat. But we might as well see if we can't at least get a little bit of gold out of it, right? Hey, nice. Okay, adventurers in Colette have proven to be a huge boost to the local economy, purchasing potions, regents, and supplies in large quantities. Thank you. Local tax modifier plus 25%. It's still going to be basically nothing. We just touched the king, which apparently makes him like us a little bit more. Well, you know how it do. What's this one? You want to buy... Oh, come on. Buy some favors from me, damn it. Fine grease you. Please support me by voting with me on the council. Absolutely not. He did offer us, but then the second the thing popped up, it disappeared just as quickly. So I'm kind of hoping he'll re-ask us, because the last time we did that, that 60 gold paid for the mercenaries that got us independent. So if he wants to offer us that, absolutely I'm going to say yes. I also don't want to piss him off, because he seems like a pretty great guy. Hroki is pregnant again. Hroki has done great things for this dynasty here. Our next son is, of course, a prodigy. How's he coming along, by the way? Nepos Diggus Biggus Julius. He's fine. Like, literally no change, really. Although he does have 9 diplomacy at the age of 3, which is more impressive than half my counselors. In fact, what's our current counselor has 20, so he's got a long way to go, but to be fair, he's an insanely skilled 3-year-old, and I'm kind of looking forward to playing his character with a bit more, you know, from the get-go. Don't get me wrong, in a short period of time, we turned this guy into an absolute powerhouse, but just starting off, you know, not having to worry about rolling the dice and getting kind of lucky would be nice for a change. There we go. Your steward comes to see you one afternoon. She explains that she's devised plans bringing exotic goods. Last time we did this, we failed basically straight up. Oh, nice. We can go up to rank 3 there. So, Defender, when do we start getting the... Okay, so the discounts come in another 2 ranks after what we're going to be in a second. Last time we did this, we failed. I did sink some money into it, more than I normally would. I'm actually kind of tempted to do this, because if we succeed, it will give us the gold, essentially, that we need straight away to make our duchy level title, and that will in turn give us more gold, because we can not be over our domain limit so much. Sure, you know what, I wouldn't normally do this, but I'm going to roll with it. Let's say no to the priests. I think we do actually have... We've got Gregarious, of course, so we could have gotten around that, I believe. I'm not going to risk it, though. We're just going to stick with it and try and get... Ooh, what was that we just got then? Oh, shit, yeah, of course. So... This is something I always forget to mention, but when you get to certain levels of your guild, so the Mage's Guild, I believe, gives you like a Ring of Aegis or something like that. When we got to level 3 there of the Fighter's Guild, they've given us a Steel Sword. So it's better than nothing. Oh my god, Martial plus 2 for a Steel Sword. That's fantastic, thank you. Right, Carpenter's Guild. Capital gets build cost, build time modifier. Oh, that's quite a lot. That's pretty decent. Yeah, I'm going to take that. We'll take the Carpenter's Guild, thank you. And we get Stewardship plus 1 as well. Man, this guy's doing well. I'm going to spend the 25 prestige to make this guy like us a little bit more, and we are going to see my good friend, High Chief Moamim the Gracious. Yeah, let's spend the gold. Let's spend the gold, see if we can do that. There we go, we touch the king again, and he likes us even more. Please excuse her, she is a barbarian, and we will not suffer barbarians. Nice, okay, we succeeded this time. That's going to give us all the gold we need to make our duchy level title. It was 100 and... Ah, it's 174. Shit, well, it doesn't matter too much, not such a big deal, huh? Commission a runestone. Why can we do that? Is that just something you can do if you're Nibbanian? Maybe it's because we have Nordic blood? I have no idea. Oh, you know what? It's probably the blood on the companions, right? I have no idea. Either way, we're not going to do it, so it doesn't really matter too much. Did we start studying specialization? No, we didn't. Shit, you fool. All right. Assassin, Barbarian, Battle Mage, Crusader, Knight, Monk, Rogue. I don't know which one is best for us right now. I'm going to probably go through the list and look up what each one... Oh, well, you know, it does say right there. Intrigue, Focus, and Martial. I kind of want Martial and Stewardship, so I think Barbarian would be pretty decent here. If we could hold all of these territories without giving any away, that's the ultimate goal, right? Martial focus with intrigue, martial with diplomacy. I'm gonna go barbarian. Fuck it. Yeah, let's go barbarian. That sounds like the most useful immediately to the realm. So we can gain greedy 50-50 on greedy and piss off our steward. I mean, she already likes this quite a lot. I would be kind of happy getting greedy as well. Yeah, that's plus 10% additional tax. So that'd be pretty decent. We got ourselves some of the tranquil voice. Interesting. That's a name I couldn't even begin to pronounce. So you, my son, we got to think of a naming scheme now. I've just been sort of very vaguely Roman slash Imperial-esque so far. I got to come up with a good naming scheme. What about different, like, well, different weapons? That'd be cool. We could have, like, Halberd Augustuson. You'll do. Right, welcome aboard. Now I got to try and think of more than just one medieval weapon. This is good, because we are a family, a powerful warrior family, descended from the companions themselves, or at least that's what, you know, we've been told. That'll do. I like this idea. So we'll train Halberd and Nepos. We'll give Augustus to Rhea, the same woman that trained us, because she's a legendary warrior, so that might rub off on him a little bit. After speaking with some local hunters, I've deduced the location of several scheme against. Die, vermin. There we go. We get 100 reputation. That, we didn't get any gold from that, because that was in our own territory, but it is kind of nice to get something out of that as well there. We're so... Oh, come on. No, I'm sorry. I would normally, but we're so close to being able to make our duchy level title. Oh, you know what? That will also give us a domain bonus, won't it? Because it's ranked times... Hey... We might be able to hold everything. That'd be fantastic, because then we wouldn't have to get out of here. You can't just keep coming back until I give you the money, you shit. Oh, I would also do this as well, but we're so close to being able to become a duke. I don't want this guy to also shuffle us under another duke as well, just to tidy up his own vassal maps. I want to do it as soon as possible. Yeah, let's ask Abner over to our palace. We don't really have a palace. We barely even have a castle. Finally talking private. Okay, Diligent or Gregarious. I guess we'll go with Gregarious. That seems to make the most sense. Oh, nice. Abner was so struck by my generosity and kindness as a host that just before departing, he tells me he feels indebted to me. This is corruption. Premium corruption right here. This guy, we've made friends with him. We've swayed him. We've got a favor from him. He's given us a strong claim on Skinnier. This is nice. I like it. I think we've proven ourselves to, like I said, the most powerful man in the empire. Okay, so he wants to switch... Wait, his ward? What? I ask permission to give my ward Halberd. What do you mean? It's my ward, you fool. Okay, fine. Seeing as if it was our best heir, I might have told him to piss off on that one. If you asked about Nepos Diggus Biggus Julius, I might be persuaded to maybe suffer some opinion hit with him, because I don't really want this kid becoming a savage. There we go. All right. Boom. Excuse me. Boom. A shortcut's apparently entered these days. Okay. County of Cropsford, which is confusingly the Duchy of Cropsford. Look at us now. Look at this fancy banner we've got. Our father would be so proud. Our mother and our grandfather would be so proud to see that we've climbed back to the lofty rank of Duke. That's nice. We've come quite far. And we still can't hold it. What is the rank times? Oh, it's just count. Okay, all right. Still times one. Fair enough then. You want me to be your commander? Sure. Why not? I mean, experienced warrior. Because we agreed to be his commander. Is that why? Oh my god, we're doing so freaking well. And what does that give us? Siege plus 12%. I love that they've actually added bonuses to martial education rather than just basically the amount of troops you get from your domain. And obviously how good you are at leading troops. I do like that you get some other little bonuses there as well. Very cool. And the personal combat makes perfect sense also. I'll deal with this directly. Sure, why the hell not? We're going to go fight some trolls. Please don't die now. Please, you've got so much to do. Come on. There we go. Okay, but we also gained 5.4. Oh, was that a quest from the Fighters Guild? I thought it was in our own domain for a second. Aha. The Demace the Mince button on my keyboard is still working as intended, I see. Thank you. That's a joke. People in Discord think I've got a Debase the Mince button. I don't, but I think that would be awesome. I don't know if you can even mod particular keyboard shortcuts to run events. If you could, though, that's a good idea. That's a good idea for a mod to put into multiplayer. The mod, the Lords of Liberty, obviously, you wouldn't be able to sneak in. You'd have to be like, oh, download my mod pack, haha. The Lords of Liberty have approved the institution of the Ruler Title Revocation Sovereignty Law. Oh, that sounds bad. I trusted you, Abnathan, and you've betrayed me. We can request a... Oh, wait, but we've got a... I thought we were requesting a claim from him in exchange for a favor. I thought that's something they've added. But no, we're asking the leader of our religion, the Arch Primate. Primer, I assume is how that's pronounced, rather than him being like a big gorilla. That's something we could definitely do in the future, is play the religious aspect of things. I didn't actually realize that we were kind of playing an almost Catholic-style religion here. So we can request claims, can request invasions. No valid targets available. Okay, fair enough. Maybe we have to be independent or something for that. I'm not entirely sure. That's cool, though. Oh, God. That does not inspire hope. Oh, my God. We've been wounded for ages, though, haven't we? Where's my court position? Do we not have a court position? Maybe we don't have a court position. Oh, God. Excuse me. Minor titles, please. We do have a court position. Hey, help me. Tertia, for the love of God, my... Oh, we don't have a court mage, who would normally be the one blasting us with the magic spell, though, right? Okay. No valid candidates. We need to invite a mage to our court very briefly and see if they will cure us very quickly. Right, let's go for 3,200 years... Oh, it's Valerica. Right, got it. And then, obviously, Serana there as well, Clan Volkaha. Have they given new portraits to the Dunmer? Or is it just... Nope. No, they have not. It's literally just Diviath Fear. Okay, I mean, that's fair enough. He's pretty influential and all that. Oh, I wonder if they've... So, obviously, when we did the last series of the Elder Kings, towards the end of it, one of the artists for the mod actually got in touch with me and basically said, hey, here's some portraits for the Dwemer. I wonder if they've actually... How do you spell it? Yagram Bagan? Okay, it's not... Oh, I'm looking for women. Right, let's go men. Okay, we go. There he is. They've actually... Oh, that's cool. That's exactly what I was hoping for right there. Look at that. Be the change you want to see in the world, and that's what I want to see more of in the world. Yagram Bagan, you sexy beast of a man. Has he got any other... He's going to see maybe, you know, some other Dwemer spawned in the court or something like that. That's cool, though. What am I looking for? I was looking for a powerful mage, and then I got distracted by sexy, sexy Dwemer triple or quadruple chins, even. Join court, yes. Right, sort by learning. We've got Justin is a mage as well. He's also necromancer, also a werewolf. Ah... Yeah, it's tempting, but I'm going to go with her instead. There's a lot of, also, I don't know if you noticed, another prodigy kicking around. This is cool. Damn it. Okay, so she's got high learning, but they actually need to have the traits, like decent mage. There you go, experienced mage or master mage. We'll invite you then, because you're a master and you have identical learning. Hopefully this guy will be able to heal us with his magical scroll. Please, do it. Blast me. Tell him of my prosperous ram, Abner. Thank you for turning a blind eye when I unjustly conquested an entire vassal of yours. Now my realm is making a lot of money. Definitely a humble brag, but it is working, apparently. And we're going to send him a message as well. Good God, we really do love this dude. So we can choose a god to worship here. I'm kind of tempted to go for the Bella again. I do like the general opinion plus 10. I think that's massive. It's so good. And then we've also got the Imperial Bureaucratic Policies, which I mentioned last episode, but I've been advised are very, very good. You can only do it every certain, you know, every certain few months or like every couple of years or something like that. But it does cost a scalable amount of wealth. So the richer we get, the more expensive the policies are going to be, which is fine. That's generally how a lot of events work. So, oh, to be fair, it's only 14.2 gold. General opinion plus 4. That's kind of nice. Okay. Levy reinforcement rate plus 15%. Levy size minus 10%. So if you're in a war, that could be very, very good. because you wouldn't really notice losing 10% of your total levy size. And where do you get that? Is that, we gain it, not our capital, which makes it even more impressive in that case. Public works project, build cost minus 10%. Oh, that's also really good. I'm actually kind of tempted to go for that one right now, because we also got the Carpenter's Guild, didn't we? So we can start building up our capital into somewhere quite decent. Now, do we want to move our capital, or do we want to commit to... I mean, to be fair, this one's already better. Draclo, we've been on this one for ages, 9.7. This one has a city as well. We can try and revoke that. I'm going to make you our capital then, and we will... Oh, but the Carpenter's Guild's here, right? Or was it... Well, did we get in the Carpenter's Guild? Or it's just completely gone? Maybe that as well. No, it was actually here. Not only that, it's also got alien druids and basic infrastructure. Oh, wow, that's really cool. Right, okay. This is going to be our brand new capital then. What do we want to build up in it? Honestly, I'm looking for anything that will give tax right now, so maybe we want to just wait a while until we've built up a little bit more gold. We don't really have that much. Now, one thing I noticed, we didn't just have one boat. We had four boats. Is that enough to go raiding? We can actually fit an army on there, which is pretty fucking nuts. All right, sure. Let's go and see what we can find out there in world. We'll send Rhea as well, so we're not risking our own neck on this one. How much gold can we take? 40 gold. Hey, 40 gold is not bad when you're making a total of 1.55 gold per month. And we're over our domain limit as well. We could give some of those away. Who do I trust with Ram? We could give it to only our own dynasty, which is a weird strategy, but I do kind of like that idea. Our aunt got married. We've now got a cousin there as well. What about our father? Is he unlanded? We give our father some lands. If he dies, you know... Oh, shit. But then our brother, Brond. Our half-brother, Brond Hrokison. What a name. Oh, but he's a monk. He took the vows. Okay, that's fine then. We could actually legitimately land our father, and I actually kind of trust him holding some land as well. Sure. And that way, when he dies, we'll get it back anyway. So it's no different to basically a viceroyalty there. You can have that one, because I think it was garbage. And one of them was literally just a church. You can have Magia as well. You can even hold them. Oh, characters of this tier, do not use vassal limit. Fine. That's, sorry, not vassal limit, domain limit. There we are. Right, we're good. You can also have this one. Council say no, because they are also unlanded. You shit. Is our wife on the council? Countess. She is. So she dies, our son gets it. Sure, whatever. Then you can have, Magia. There you go, my friend. Alright, so our wife holds some land. When she dies, our son gets it. And our father holds some land. So when he dies, we get it anyway. So I'm pretty happy with that being dished out the way we have. Let's stand all of these guys down. There we go. I need to get the bigger interface mod back, because I'm so used to the shortcuts from that one. I'll see if I can sort that out for next episode. Meanwhile, we're going to go raiding. And then we're also going to fight some bandits and probably die. Oh god, why did I say that? We can actually... Oh, okay, we can't die, but we can become maimed. 1%, because we're such a fucking powerhouse these days. The Great Port of Senchal has been burnt. Is that what I'm looking at right here? Yeah, I was kind of looking for somewhere to raid, but apparently these guys have absolutely no loot whatsoever. Does anywhere have loot not protected by a loot bar? Good god, look at them. Like, everywhere. Oh, Palace of the Main, there are so many great wonders. I mean, credit to the dev team for churning this shit out this quickly, huh? Oh my god, all the places without a loot bar have been basically picked apart. I bet it's bloody Orgnum, isn't it? Get out of here, you goddamn sea elves. Don't make me go to war with you guys as well. Alright, let's check out... I mean, Black Rose at least has something. Great, we can get 4 gold. Wow. please, this is gonna be just anything. I'll take anything. Here we go. Mirkwood. That'll do. Okay, right, let's go and raid the Woodland Realm. Quickly, go up here, right. Excellent. What a great raid. Good god. And how much did we get out of that? 4 gold. And now we make our escape. Oh my god. There's got to be somewhere better than this. This is garbage. The thing is, we're always going to have to sail down through the Nibbin Bay. So, I mean, what the hell else can we find here? Unless there's... I mean, I don't want to go much further than this. It's going to be ridiculous, especially for 40 gold as well. We're going to be going on these ridiculously, like, micromanaged worldwide tours. And we're going to get barely anything out of it. Because we've got to stick to Argonia, huh? But even then, Argonia barely bloody has anything. Ideally, we need to burn something down, don't we? But we're not going to be able to burn anything down until we get about 800 troops. All right, I see the way we've got to go. We've got to just build up some ships or something along those lines. Oh, God, loads of people dying all of a sudden. We've got to build up some more boats and then maybe go out raiding with that after the fact. Oh, God, you select 12 of the bravest, most capable men. Don't die, don't die. It's a good day to die. No, it's not. It's a bad day to die. Please don't die. Oh, thank you. 3% chance your veterancy with leadership in combat is increased, did we? We got nothing. Okay, well, I suppose we actually could be leading these raids personally. Halberd, what is it, my son? You could potentially get into... I don't see the downside to that event ever. You neglect your responsibilities and all that, but it just does not seem worth it to get cruel and, like, piss off your kids as well. Nice. 12 gold. Hey, it might not be much, but that's equivalent to, what, like, a year's salary, so I'll take it. Jastria Augustus, daughter, how are you? Kind of garbage. Okay. Medieval weapons, did I say, right? You're going to be called Mace. Welcome, Mace Augustus. I was trying to say Mace or God. I should call it like Dagger or some shit, you know, Shiv. You can be trained in etiquette. You will be a lovely young lady, and you will secure for me a powerful marriage alliance. All right. There's no fucking gold anywhere. My God. I'm trying to stick to, like, these Argonian lakes, because, of course, we can sail basically all the way around Argonia, anywhere there's a major river we can get to. The issue is, they've got a lot more troops in, so they don't want to risk our only capable army of raiding, because otherwise our troops will literally be so big that we can't fit them on the damn boats. So you've got to be very, very careful. And we're risking all of this to get, like, 2 gold? It's really not worth it, huh? Oh, nice. They give us a superior silver sword for hitting a higher level. Are they just going to give us better and better gear as we level up here? That's pretty fantastic. Now, was there not a way to sell artifacts in this mod? I honestly don't remember. I feel like there wasn't. Oh, I know what we do with them. We chuck them at Daedra, don't we? Okay. In that case, not really too interested. We're not going to worship any Daedra for the time being. Well, that's something for the future. We're still just working our way. We're still feeling our way through the realm of politics, you know? Now's not the time to start getting involved with all sorts of outer deities or anything like that. We're just going to stick to simple pleasures. Gold and land. Perfect. Let's put these troops down, and let's see if we can't upgrade, I mean, I guess, some sort of shipyard, maybe? You got any of them shipyards? No. Okay, good. Legionnaire barracks. Okay, how much do we need to save up, then? Come on. Oh, shit. Don't forget, we've also got to be very careful. I do also have the loan to pay off. Shipbuilding level 2, large hall level 3. Large hall level 3 is miles away. Oh, God, there's got to be something here, right? Toll stations gives us nothing. Looking for anything that sounds like it could give us boats. Shit. Fishing guild? Nothing. Oh, that's fighters guild. Fishing guild. My God. Do you guys remember that fishing guild in Oblivion? That was my favorite. I'm going to pay off that 60 gold then. Why not? We might as well get rid of it. That way we've really got nothing to worry about. We can open our spellbook and do absolutely nothing here. Opposite to just completely blank pages. Fantastic. Maybe we should just rely on the fighters guild for a while. I mean, we're still young. We're still kind of also going to die. This infection is just not healing, huh? Wounded is just not pissing off. Excuse me. Oh, God damn it. Oh, sell an artifact. There's literally a button for that. Thank you. Superior steel sword. Get rid of it. 25 gold. I mean, we've got it for free anyway, so we might as well roll with it. Court physician. Do you actually want to do something here? You seem a bit garbage. You're sacked. You're a terrible court physician. You're doing nothing for me. I don't like that at any second we could potentially drop down dead. This is not fantastic. Why don't we go to war and claim... Oh, we still can't because he's... So how long until that one's worn off? 3 years. Then we can become a double duke. Hopefully by then, this infection or this wound or whatever can disappear. Because we're basically on death's door at all point. We got -3 health, which is super significant. The kingdom is agnatic cognatic elective, is it really? Nominate Count Augustus the Traitor. Okay, well, it's not the best platform to run on, is it? As King of Nibene. That would be fantastic if one character we go from being a crappy little count up to, well, Baron in this, up to King of Nibene. No pressure. I will ask this guy if he wants to be my friend. That's wonderful. He has lost a lot of opinion of us because apparently we possess this as a vassalage now, which he's not best pleased of because he wants it because it's technically part of his realm. That's kind of annoying, but I also don't really give a shit about what he thinks to that extent. I mean, he's already given us enough. He's only got 20 opinion of us these days, which does suck a little bit. We're fucking dead.
Why? Why? It didn't heal.
Jesus, I'm averaging like 2 freaking characters an episode here. Died of an infected wound, although not especially blessed. We hope Augustus will find peace in the afterlife. We lost 2 barony titles. Cool. Dear son, may the gods guide you. I've been appointed as your... Back to being baby again. Oh, to be fair, we are insane. Oh, shit, and he's rowdy and willful. This kid's a powerhouse. This kid's a fucking powerhouse. Okay, maybe that's not such a bad thing then. Horik takeover, Denari, yeah, whatever. We'll just quickly set the council up here. What can we do? Imperial bureaucratic policies. What, at the age of baby? We can compose a butt, though. What did we lose then? So we just lost. We didn't actually lose them. They're still within our realm. We've just sort of lost control over them. We might want to take those back. You know, maybe you could just die horribly. Just die horribly? Okay, if we get the option to kill our younger brothers, that's definitely on the cards. Especially Halberd. Halberd's garbage. Shit, we don't even have access to the sea anymore. God, Halberd, you've really got to die. Augustus was the shit one. Well, Halberd, you're still going to die, though. Yeah, that's really garbage. That's, like, extremely garbage. Have we still got that strong claim on? Okay, we did have a strong claim. We never got a weak claim on this one. So we do need to press it in war whenever the hell we can. I think we might have sent the Dark Brotherhood after him or something. Martial education, that's what we're talking about. Right, look at that. Rowdy and willful. I think this kid's going to come out incredibly good. Who are you? Get out of here. Right, we need to find a good military person to teach us. Why have we got so many... Look at this guy. Oh, my God, and he's diligent. And he's brawny. Adventurer. I don't even know who you are, but welcome. Nice. Well, that's a hell of an educator right there, huh? Our grandfather died, Baron Horik of Var Tarchin. Apparently fucking remarried and had a baby in the time that he took to die? You shit. Well, I mean, we're still this kid's heir then. Could we kill the child? There's so many kids we've got to kill. This is unbelievable. She's got a whole list of kids we've just got to get rid of. She's got to throw them straight in the... Oh my god, speaking of kids we've got to get rid of. Close the gate. I am saving the money up so that when we get this province back that we can start building up some boats, but I'm kind of more tempted to be, you know, writing a book or doing literally anything more useful right now. Shut the gates. Close the gates. Seal it shut. I do not want to die. This character's really good, and we've died so fucking frequently in this campaign so far. To put it into perspective, we've died more times in this campaign so far than all in the previous two Elder Scrolls series combined. Oh god. Oh god, have mercy. Cancer. Okay, please just let it be the flu. Please let it be a cold. What was it that swept through the area? Whitbane. What the hell is Whitbane? Have you got, wait, who was it we wanted to inherit from? You? He's got Whitbane. What is Whitbane? Symptoms include memory loss and disorientation. Personal comments come minus 40. Oh, it's a health minus 4. Shit. Affecting the victim's memory, thought processing ability to regenerate magicka. Why can I see it now? We're gonna die, but he's gonna survive Whitbane. And then we're gonna end up playing as friggin' Halberd. Come on. That's if it is. Oh shit, we got Brawny. I didn't even notice that. We don't even have Whitbane. We have Stomach Rot. Well, that's not much fucking better. I mean, it is better. Doesn't sound much better, though. Great. We avoided the horrendous disease sweeping through our castle, but instead we got an arguably awful sounding disease as well. Thank you. I think we're going to be fine, especially because we've got Brawny also. What did we have that gave us Brawny then? Isn't Willful not the one that turns into Brawny? I have no idea. Oh, apparently we also got Temperate as well. Thank you very much. And we lost Stomach Rot by being a bit more temperate and not eating, I don't know, rotten flesh off the floor. So this one becomes Ambitious, Brave, Stubborn, or Uncouth. I mean, Ambitious and Brave would obviously be just ridiculously good. Brawny is already incredible. This kid, I've got a good feeling about you, tiny child. Let's release you from your prison. 250 gold. How's he doing? Is he dead from Whitbane yet? Oh, he actually survived it. Wow, okay. Nothing to worry about. We've got missing... Ah, you'll do. Yeah, absolutely. Let's get our marshalers. He's got 26 marshal? Excuse me? And we, more to the point, have 17 diplomacy to go along with it. This kid's going to be a powerhouse. He might be better than the last character, and that was a really, really great character. Granted, kind of after the fact he's finished his education. Right, 2 more months, and we'll get to see if he is completely trash or not. Here we go. Boom. Come on. Come on. Legendary warrior. You can't get legendary warrior, as far as I know. But level 4? Experienced warrior. You know what? I'll take it. And we got brave. Oh, shit, that's a good character. Count Nepos the Second. Technically it's Count Nepos II, but of course the original Nepos was of wherever the hell this dynasty comes from. Okay, war it is. Do we even want war right now? Maybe we want to go business focus for the time being, or maybe even intrigue. Because I did notice, if we go to the marketplace, we can visit an alchemist and buy a potion of chameleon. That gives plot power increase plus 133% for 60 gold. If, say for example, our half-brother were to disappear horribly, we would get a ridiculous amount of chance against him doing that. I think this could work. I genuinely think this could be an okay idea. No one wants to join us. Let's buy the potion and see if it works. Okay, let's do it. 223%. And how long does that last? Lasts for 5 years? That's got to be... They've got to have accidentally put in an extra one there, right? I mean, to be fair, if we're fucking invisible, you kind of imagine we could get shit done, huh? Go and oversee us. Build a spy network in this one as well. Goodbye, brother. It was nice knowing you. Ooh, and we can potentially get deceitful. Man. Oh, we didn't get it. That's a real shame, because that would have really helped out with our intro game, huh? You want me to be a spy master too? To be fair, I would kind of want an invisible man to be my spy master as well. I think that's got its benefits, or it's got its massive, massive drawbacks now that I think about it. Elect your friend. Who do we want to elect here? Hang on. Nepos. Elect Nepos Biggus. What did I call him? Diggus Biggus. And 30 gold for you, my friend. Even though I'm trying to save gold, but sure, you can have that. I have a feeling this kid won't be long for the world anyway. Oh my god. To Count Nepos of Cropsford. I believe you're in possession of expertise that will prove invaluable to the Elder Council. I urge you join our ranks in the Imperial City. It is an honor. Or do we say, our time has not yet come, and work our way up through some societies a little bit more? I mean, what does that do for us? Participate in council vote, council powers, chief councillor, high councillor, change out of council policies. I don't know that now's the time. I think it's incredible, but I don't think now's the time. I think we could definitely turn our character, make our character a lot better. We could improve our realm a lot more. I think our time is... We're not yet ready, my friend. Thank you. I appreciate that you are willing to make a 16-year-old guy a member of the Elder Council, but let's wait. He did give us the amulet, though. The amulet's still ours permanently. I like that. Thank you. And we've invented screaming arrows. This guy, you thought his father was going to be a military genius. This guy, 10 out of 10. No, we're not going to do that. We're not killing anyone, thank you. We are not the type of guy to kill anyone ever. So I think we'll be avoiding any sort of other round plots. I don't want to get mired in, you know, revenge and that type of thing. Okay, so, also, what about this kid? This kid needs to disappear. If you could die as well. Oh, shit, what's he got? Fire and Faith. He's got a rare artifact, apparently, and that's what that counts as. Nechunak's Fire and Faith. You need to disappear. I'm not a fan of these houses being inspired. Oh my god, matrilineally? No. They're going to inherit this. You need to disappear. Goodbye. Thank you. Can't afford it. Shit. Kidnap him? I mean, I'd rather deal with our brother first, because this kid is going to be a long time before he potentially has any heirs. So we'll deal with that when... I mean, we've got essentially another 12 years before this kid starts becoming an issue. Thank you for watching. Yet again, we've got through two characters in one episode, but look at Nepos. Nepos is absurd. Nepos, the ridiculously overpowered military ruler. Actually, not a huge amount better than his father. But we are definitely... I mean, the graph's increasing with each generation. So maybe if this guy dies off, his next heir could be even better still. We'll marry for bloodlines this time, if we can. I don't know if there are any sort of matrilineal inheritance or whatever the equivalent would be for women. This one, but for ladies. I don't know if there are any bloodlines of that even exist. So I think we would have to marry off matrilineal if we wanted a bloodline, which obviously we're not going to do. So we might just still have to worry about maybe getting... Maybe if we go for, like, strong... Try and get, like, a prodigy and strong. I don't know. That might be overstepping it a little bit. Maybe we want a guaranteed prodigy. I don't know. We'll talk about that next time. It's been a fantastic episode. The age of 16 already asked to join the Elder Council. That's a step in the right direction. Thank you all for watching. Let's give a shout out to the insane top tier level patrons who made the series possible in the first place. A big thank you to Alpha Scuff, Asuna Kirito, Atmosis, Average Gamer 419, Bacon Kitten, Sardini, Crazy Pack, Crosis, Donald, Facundo Vasquez, Fluffernutter, Fungus King, Gogolas, Harik, Jimbo, Josh Lindin, Tesla, Justin Wallace, Kaden Carter, Michael Mullen, Mr. Smug, Muskratful, Necrofillin, Nathan Flores, Pelvis Presley, Skaz, Surfall the Swede, Stannis Manis, The Forsaken One, Toby Cruz, Tom Terror 18, Tyler Kendall, and Vacuous Bacchus. Thank you for your support, the Insane Tier Lovers on Patreon. Thank you for making this series possible in the first place. My god, what a great series it's been so far, huh? We've just been ridiculously lucky with certain characters, but then also simultaneously the most unlucky playthrough I've ever seen. Like, we should still be on our first character, I think, right? How much time has passed in-game? Let me just check very briefly. 38 years. We should definitely still be on our first character, but nope. We've just been 38 years and we got through four characters. Jesus. Big shout-out as well to Andrew Wilson, Ben Troke, Betamus Max, Beta Valerian, Chris, David Van Diepen, Don27, Fraser Brennan, Gabriel Faulkner, Gabriel Van Derz, Gaz, GWK Run, Genji Zerka, Gray, Haji Damar, Hancock, Icy the Great, Irish, Israel, Jay Lara, James Barnes, Jose, Jason, Yoran DeVries, John Holiday, Jordan Campbell, Joseph Beard, Justin Plot, Justin Walters, Lemon Start, Lasmee, Luana Thomas, Luke Wallace, Matthew, Monty, Nathaniel Lindbergh, Nick, Noah Gallimore, Pan Samu, Panther Pearl, Peyton Dennis Art, Rush Nogart, Billionaire, The Insane Pickle, Will Wade, Wesley Grayson, Wolfie, Yorkus, Zach Pillar, Zico, and I think I might have left out Asro, Adam Person, and Akari too. See you guys all tomorrow.